to our call to relationship. And our call to relationship, we talk about the fact that first we have to have a relationship with God. And our relationship with God really dictates what our relationship would be with one another. If we have a good relationship with God, then we're able to be in relationship with each other. But if you have a dicey relationship with God's love. If I don't quite understand God's love, then that part in the scripture where it talks about the love is patient, we talked about this in Bible study last week. The love is patient and love is kind. And tell me some other things that love is. I don't know. Yes.
Long-suffering.
Long-suffering.
Patient.
Happiness.
Love is humble.
Understanding. Humble. Patient. So we have all these things that love is. So, if love is those things, and we are not exhibiting those things to others, then are we being loving? We're not being loving, right? So first we have to remember, so if we go back to our scripture for today, as I told the kids, Jesus, it was not his best day. He had just found out that John had been beheaded. He wasn't feeling his best, probably sort of blaming himself. If it hadn't been for me, Jesus wouldn't have been in there predicament. So probably feeling a little bit, a little down. So he just needed to get away. He just wanted to go spend some time in prayer. He just wanted to talk to God and say, why did you have to let this happen? Do we sometimes feel that way? Sometimes we don't understand what's going on around us, and we just need some time to say, Lord, what's going on here? Trish was praying for one thing. She thought it was coming one way, and probably when it came another way, she had to say, okay, Lord, let's talk about this for a minute. That really wasn't where I was thinking we were going with this. Not right at this moment in time. Well, she said, let's pray about this. Let's see where it is that we're headed. So while Jesus was trying to get away to pray, the next thing he knows, he looks up and the disciples are like, yo dude, or in the words of Rich, yo bro, there's a bunch of folk out here looking for you. They heard that you've been healing people, and there's some people here who need to be healed. Jesus was probably thinking, this is not the day. This is not the day for you. But instead, he said, it's not about me. It's not about me. So let me just exhale and go and meet the people and see what their needs are. So he spent some time healing them and taking care of their needs. And then it started getting a little late. So the disciples came and said, oh, his mom gave him a fish salad before he left on the journey. But it's about 5,000 folks out there. So I'm not really thinking that we're going to feed 5,000 with the one fish sandwich. So I think we should just send them on their way, thank them for coming, and tell them to be safe, to have a safe journey, whether they got to leave now, because we've got no food for them. We've got nothing else. We've given them all that we have, and that they have to go. And Jesus said, no. We've got more than enough. Mm-hmm. And the disciples were like, I don't know what kind of man. But dude, not only are you looking at the men, but did you see the women and the children also? We gotta feed everybody. We can't just feed some folk. We gotta feed everybody. Jesus said, we've got more than enough. So just do what I tell you to do. Bring what you have here. And we're going to put in some baskets. Have the people sit down. And we're going to all eat together. I'm going to bless it. We're going to divide it out amongst the people. And what happened at the end? Was it more than enough?
Yes.
It was more than enough. We had leftovers. We had some stuff to take back home. So when we think of fellowship, we think, okay, we're just going to come and we're going to laugh and have a great time. But sometimes, you know, there's things called rules of engagement. I want to say sometimes we have rules of fellowship. We have rules of fellowship. The first thing is, even in times when we don't feel like it, sometimes we have to put our needs aside for the needs of others. Okay? Sometimes we have to put our needs aside for the needs of others. Sometimes the people who work in the food pantry, they could probably think of 100 things they could be doing on Saturday morning. They could be baking bread. They could be sleeping in. They could be doing the laundry. They could be doing the dishes. They could be cooking. They're probably thinking of, they could be doing their homework. There are 100 things that they could be doing. But it really is a time of fellowship. Not only do they come and they meet the needs, but they greet them nicely. The people come in, they always have a smile and a hug and ask them how they're doing. And if they haven't seen them in a while, they let them know that. Hey, we haven't seen you in a couple of months. How's everything been going? Is everything okay? They're not sitting there telling them, oh, I'm so glad you made it, that it's almost over because my hand hurt, my finger hurt, my toe hurt, I don't want to be here, I have a hunger. That's not what they say. They put themselves aside so that they can help someone else in need. So the first thing is sometimes we have to be selfless and not selfish. Another rule of engagement, sometimes we have to be compassionate. Sometimes we have to be compassionate. Jesus was compassionate. It wasn't really what he wanted to do, but he was like, they need me. Sometimes we spend time thinking about what we need and what we want, and not about what others need and what others want, and what will help them to see Jesus. Because sometimes we're not focusing on what will help us to see Jesus. We're just talking about, I don't like that cup of coffee. And we're going to have a whole long argument, and everybody's going to be mad, and half the church is going to leave, all about the color of the coffee. And you know what? That doesn't help anyone to have a relationship with Christ. In fact, what it does is it turns them off, because it says that those people in that building are crazy as all get out, and why would I want to go and be a part of it? If their biggest concern is what color is the carpet, and half of them are going to leave because they don't like the color of the carpet, they need to meet Jesus themselves.
Amen.
They can't help me because they haven't met him yet. So we have to be compassionate. We have to be compassionate. So the first thing is, sometimes we have to put others' needs before ours. The second one is that we have to be compassionate. Yeah, And the third one is, we have to provide for others. Oh, I had three P's. Oh, y'all know I like to do the things together. So the first one, putting the needs of others before us. The second one was, oh, this is it. Pay no attention, not listening to those around you. Because what did the disciples say? We don't know. We are not. They're always going to be the naysayers. They're always going to be the naysayers. But sometimes we've got to, remember last week, because sometimes we've got to trust God. Because sometimes with our physical eyes, we can't see the whole picture. We can't see the God picture. And so there will always be others, but y'all are crazy. Y'all are crazy. Y'all are following this man all over the place. Y'all ain't never seen him before. You all are crazy. So sometimes we have to put that negativity aside. Joe's not in here. So y'all tell her that when she comes back in, the negativity that she's worried about, what people are going to be calling her and what they're going to be saying about her, she's got to put that aside. We've got to focus on the main thing. You go to school, you get your education, you do your work, you listen to your teachers, you do what you're supposed to be doing. And it's great to have friends, but those who don't want to be your friends, you pray for them and keep on moving. Don't let them ruin your life. Don't get stuck on what somebody else is saying about you. They don't like your shoes, tell them that's fine. You ain't got to wear them, so I don't care whether you like them or not. They my shoes. I bought them, you don't like them, I bought them because I like them. Oh, well, mama bought them because I like them. They don't like your dress today. They don't like your hairstyle. That's fine. That's, you know what? Don't, you know what? That's great. That means I'll never have to worry about you being dressed like you. I ain't want to be your twin anyway. We have to not get caught up in the negativity. We have to put that aside. When people said, no, you can't, you say, you're right, I can't, but God can. I can't. I can't. We can't. But God can. I can't grow Oak Chapel. But God can. Right? Peggy can. No matter how hospitable she is. Jeanette, no matter how hospitable she is, Karen can sing the wings of a bird, but she cannot grow Oak Chapel by herself. But if all of us put God first, we don't need another building. That third phase that didn't never get built. We're going to have to start another building over there. We got to get some space. Because God can. So we have some rules of engagement. And our rules of engagement are exactly this for fellowship. That first of all, sometimes we have to put the needs of others before our own. We have to be selfless and not selfish. Secondly, pay no attention to those around you who are the naysayers. God can do the amazing. And third, sometimes we have to provide for others, whether it's out of our abundance or out of our scarcity. Even though it may look like we don't have enough, we've got more than enough. And if you don't believe it, you try to feed 5,000 folks with 5 loaves and 2 fish. Okay? More than enough. We had a potluck last month. I was concerned. The sign up sheet, I was like, oh my gracious, we're going to have some watermelon, some cookies. I was like, oh my goodness gracious, I was like, honey, what, you know, this is our first potluck, what do you think? And so we said, you know, my husband doesn't get ruffled. I live in a home completely different. He's like, let's just see
what happens. I said, should we go buy some chicken? What do you think we should use this for?
We had what? More than enough. We had a feast. Everybody ate, everybody was content, and plates still went home with people.
Because sometimes you just have to trust God.
That it's all going to work out. So we have some rules of engagement for our time of fellowship. And so we have to remember our call to action is not only about the things that we say, but about the things that we do.
And what we're supposed to do is to love God
with everything that we have, and to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Because how can we say that we love one whom we have not seen and hate our brother and sister? Because our brother and sister may dare you